Live now. So I said it is a close encounter. I said it's a close encounter with a familiar outcome.
Outcome, exactly. Raj, before we went on air, we normally discuss yesterday's match and today's match generally. Today, as it happened, we never got down to discuss cricket at all. So that's kind of a reflection on the match that we had last night.
Yes.
In a sense, in terms of result, I mean, the match as it was pretty interesting, scrappy, and it was good to watch in the sense. But it didn't kindle our basic interest or it didn't whet our appetite in a strange kind of way, isn't it, Raj?
Yes, very true, actually. See, at the end of the first innings, when they scored 130 plus change, I thought this would be one-sided. But then, in a way, it was not one-sided. They really, it was a bit of a...
Dogfight.
I mean, and that was fun to watch. Right. True. I mean, they really took it to the extreme. And it was so that way the match had all the right ingredients, but somehow it still seemed underwhelming. So you are right on that.
It never reached the height. The pulsation was missing.
Yeah. You didn't have performances which you could sort of sit back and say, oh, wow. So yeah. The best one was Kane Williamson, who was basically clinical. He just took it up and said, okay, I'm guiding this. Okay, he had one chance. And the look Kohli gave to Devdutt Padikkal after that was...
But that was a great effort by Devdutt.
I know, which is why I said... So I think Virat Kohli, so Devdutt Padikkal should come and say, you take that man first. I mean, he reached it because of his 6'4". Kohli wouldn't have even got there.
Exactly.
Yeah. Unless, of course, Superman was standing there. AB de Villiers.
AB de Villiers. But to see Williamson and another son, Jason... To do it for a team that was won by the Sun Group was in a sense.
that brought out the irony, I guess, in a way.
But but it was great to see them, two captains of their red ball cricket, New Zealand and West Indies, Jason Holder and Ken Williams are captains for their respective test teams. They put out a very, as you said, clinical is the word, and very cool and collected way they went about the chase was very good. It was, when you read it, it is great, but when you watch it is not so great.
Yeah, it was almost like, they said, okay, now that you have had your hour of moment of glory, now we are taking over. I mean, you just go through your motions, we'll go through our motions. And in the in the process, there were no emotions. So...
Exactly. And,
yeah.
But RCB, to be fair, they really missed Chris Morris, who was unfortunately out with the injury.
Yeah.
So if he had been there, the match could have been tighter, even could have gone that way.
Yeah. So I liked some of the things that they did yesterday. For example, Virat Kohli opening, I think we mentioned that.
Exactly.
Mohammad Siraj opening, I have been talking about that for long. So see, I think that has been the big problem with RCB this time. I mean, as in the past. Just too many change of personnel no clear role. So, Siraj opened the bowling because Chris Morris...
You have been saying this right from day one.
So, for me, that is the challenge. I mean, Siraj has been... imagine yesterday. Would Siraj have opened the bowling if Chris Morris was there?
No clear definition.
Yeah.
Exactly. That is the point.
That is the point. Yeah. And, yesterday they had SRH also had a forced change, which I thought... it didn't augur well because Srivats Goswami kept well. He was quite good behind the stumps. I think he's also part of the same team that Virat Kohli was in the under-19s, if I'm not mistaken.
Exactly. Yeah. Same.
Yeah.
Because Vridhiman Zaha has been the standout player last three matches for Sunrisers.
Yeah.
To miss his service was very difficult to rise up to the occasion. Unfortunately, that was not the case with RCB. But it came down to that eventually.
Yes. So, I just didn't get that the four changes that they made. I mean, they dropped Josh Philippe and you brought in Aaron Finch. And Finch probably scored as many runs as Philippe has been scoring in the last two matches. So this is where
that's a bottom line of the thing. But I was surprised by Moeen Ali's inclusion.
Yeah. So I think we are having an internet problem for some reason.
That was a brain fade, man. The way.
Yeah.
Is that okay? Is it
okay? Yeah. Now it's back.
Yeah. That was a brain fade moment, man. Moeen Ali.
Yeah.
The Moeen Ali run out See, you get a red carpet in the sense of a free hit. Yeah. It didn't come off, which is fine. But to run on the, you have rating straight to the fielder, to run on that is absolute unpardonable. But I'll tell you one thing, there is only one instance of a batsman getting out on a no ball. I mean, getting out through a run out on a no ball is Kedar Jadhav. But the crucial, even more thing is, he did it when he was playing for
RCB.
Yeah, exactly. Kedar Jadhav had a run out of a no ball when he was playing for RCB. So I think RCB does that to you.
Yeah, so see, yeah, for me it was like they say, no, there was for most of the evening when I was feeling melancholy, because I was seeing RCB not really sort of cutting it right from the beginning. Kohli did the right thing. He came in.
Exactly.
He came in and he got out. And then I went to collect the pizza, came back, and I found Edith Padikkal is also out. I said, like, how can, I mean, even pizza delivery, you know, pizza delivery is not that fast. But then these guys suddenly got out. And after that, I mean, nobody was trying to sort of stick it out, if you notice. So for me, I think that there, again, the batting. And then you had this comedy.
Moin Ali.
Yeah, Moin Ali comedy happened. So, I mean, Mohammad Siraj was hitting cute shots, man. That was the ultimate.
Exactly. But Raj, what was your idea of Natarajan's Yorker to De Villiers?
To me, that was the turning point. That was the turning point of the match. We can always have hindsight vision, like what was it, 2020 in hindsight. But to me, I mean, AB De Villiers playing another 10-12 balls, the score would have been at least another 20-30. Yeah, I'm sure it would have been there. We can always say that if it had been 20-30 more, SRH would have played differently. We can set all of that. But to me, that crucial moment, that crucial that ball that he... And he had the guts to ball that ball to AB De Villiers, because if there is anybody in world cricket today who can actually deal with a Yorker, I think it is ABD. And although ABD has retired from all other forms of cricket,
as you keep saying, he's a 360 player. He can scoop it. One player can get the maximum out of AB De Villiers.
That's the point. So for me, that was the game changer. That particular moment, that Yorker coming in, I think was just too good. And how he managed that, how he had the courage to sort of bowl that, and then he sort of does it. I mean, it's one thing to have courage and then end up bowling a full toss. So, which is what we have seen quite a few guys do. So, I think that was... And he just pitched it. It was pitch perfect. See, people were... I'll give you one more example. I mean, at that time, the commentary team was talking about a similar Yorker bowled by Bumrah to knock off Shikhar Dhawan. I don't think that was the same, because one, Shikhar Dhawan was new to the crease. Two, Bumrah bowled a Yorker. Shikhar Dhawan actually missed the line completely. Here, it was on middle stump. Yeah.
You talked of it yesterday.
Yeah, yesterday we spoke. This was on middle stump. You don't miss the line on middle stump usually in any form of cricket. So that is where you expect the bloody ball to be. You miss it on either side, not in the middle stump. So I'm sure this is a story for Natarajan. When he's 65 years old, he'll tell his grandchildren, "Hey, on the tugidana."
Raja, immediately after that wicket, during our WhatsApp exchanges, you made a huge call that he should have been part of the Indian, at least part of the Indian cricket team's bowling lineup, especially in the shorter formats.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought it was a huge call. Can you elaborate on that?
Simple. Who are the people who are on tour?
You're talking about shorter formats, you're talking about the Deepak Chahari, Shardul Thakur,
Saini, these three bowlers.
Siraj.
Is he playing shorter format? I don't think. I think he's playing only the... Is it? I can't remember now. Forgot. But then...
Yeah, same here.
Yeah. But then I feel that at this point, see, if you can include a Varun Chakravarti based on one IPL, what harm has this guy done?
It's a good question to ask.
Yeah. To me, I think if Varun Chakravarti took 17 wickets and he probably was the success of KKR in this season. I'll put it that way. I think SRH owes a big round of applause or whatever you call it for Natarajan for getting those. See, he has taken care of the last overs. I mean, even Bhuvi used to go for. Yeah, even Bhuvi used to go for runs in the last overs. Natarajan has gone, hasn't gone for plenty. Not only that, he has actually taken wickets in the death overs, which you have not seen Indian bowlers do, mind you. You always, most teams would have foreign bowlers bowl the last overs.
Exactly.
Yeah, so.
I would obviously pick Natarajan.
Yeah.
Simple.
Yeah, yeah. As simple as that, because I feel he deserved it. So.
And another thing I wanted to talk about SRH's selection thing, because Jason Holder came into the scheme of things only because Mitchell Marshall was injured. There wasn't, Jason Holder was not in the scheme of things in the first place. I mean, don't you think that was an inspired choice?
Oh, yes. It was an
great call.
Yeah.
So Jason Holder doesn't play for West Indies T20 team. He has no place for, the West Indies does not have place for Jason Holder in its T20 11.
Yeah.
I mean, T20 squad itself, not T20 11.
Yeah. So Jason Holder proved a point. So I think it has, see, there have been some personal battles that have been fought in this IPL. It's been good to see. I think Jason Holder is one of them. I mean, the two inspired choices, one was Saha exactly. at the top and one was Holder in the middle. I mean, that sort of seemed to change things for them.
Suddenly, I like the fact they didn't go back to attempting to go back to Barstow rather than Srivat Goswami.
Yeah.
But they didn't do that.
Yeah, so see, if they had taken Barstow, it's only one of Jason Holder or Williamson who would have played. And who won? Won them the match.
Both of them.
Yeah. So I mean, Dave Warner would probably be giving a bottle of champagne to the guy who decided that on his behalf, unless he himself decided it.
Frankly, I mean, it's a borderline case. With Williamson as well as he batted, I thought Jason Holder deserved the man of the match because it's an all-round show.
Yes, I feel so. I also felt so. But then man of the match,
it's a borderline thing.
Yeah, I think I think man of the match awards are not very relevant anymore. Barring that that 2 minutes in front of the camera, I don't think it does anything much.
So, exactly.
I think seriously, in T20s and all, it doesn't matter these days. So earlier there was, I mean, the man of the match used to feel like a man of the match. Yeah, though TK was come and stand. Oh, that fellow, he had to go to the bathroom, so he's not free. So we'll give you the man of the match. Come and stand here. I don't know. I mean, that is the way it looks like. And this is not the only one.
That's okay, but. Exactly. And getting back to RCB, it's the same old story because they were flattered to deceive and Isala Cup namade nahi hai. So that's, I mean, it's sad because I thought Kohli deserved a chance, but it happens. Now looking forward to the other, I mean, the semi-final before the final, DC and the former DC SRH.
Yeah.
Where do you think the match will be decided and how it will pan out?
See, I mean, I hate to use the word momentum. I just used it. Momentum is definitely with...
Exactly.
So momentum
it's simple,
is,
man. Yeah. DC is coming off a loss. SRH is coming after win. It's very simple.
And DC seems to have more to lose than SRH at this moment. At least that is the way their body language shows. SRH seems to be having a ball of it. Though, boils down to that one fact. DC needs one brilliant batting performance, which can happen from one of the top guys. I don't know what they're going to do with Prithvi Shaw because Prithvi Shaw is just completely out of sorts. I just don't understand what is happening to the guy. He got enough chances. So what they will do with the team would be interesting to see tomorrow. SRH is on a roll and I'm assuming that Saha will be back. So, SRH, I think, will do exactly. If they win the toss, they will bowl first. Restrict. And so, then, like I was telling our friend Gautam yesterday, it's not as if you want to score fast. But then the point is, the other team is not going to let you do that, right? It's like Virat Kohli saying, we allowed them to bowl to their strengths. Okay, boss, fine. That is your problem, not their problem. He said, last 4-5 matches, everything we have been hitting is going to fielders. But they're not dropping from the sky, right? They're there. I didn't get that.
Cut him some slack, man.
Yeah, it is not cutting him slack. That is only slack. There is nothing to cut. It is full slack only.
The entire team was slack.
So, I mean, I would say only one thing. I don't think RCB needs to change personnel now. I think they have a pretty decent team. This is, again, I'm sort of making a big call here. Maybe look at, I don't know. I mean, if at all you need one person, you need a standby for post ABD. You need to build up a future ABD, because ABD will also be walking into the sunset sooner than later. And what better than get a person at that number 4-5 slot? Virat Kohli opens. I mean, I think his best successes have come when he opened. I mean, he had them 800-900 run IPL, remember? He was opening all the matches there. Opens, you don't have a problem there. You have ABD at number 3 or 4, or a pinch hitter at number 3 and ABD at 4. You need a 5 who can actually do a Hardik Pandya when you need it, or a Kyron Pollard. I mean, if you think about it, none of the other teams have that. I mean, if you think about it, I think the closest that any other team comes to that, I mean, Owen Morgan, of course, is an exception. I mean, he's a proper batsman. You don't have a guy who can sort of just come in 10 balls.
Keep clearing.
Yeah, 10 balls, 30 runs. Those are the guys you want at that point who can actually maximize.
Somebody like Dinesh Karthik, 17 over Dinesh Karthik.
So, see, some of these guys, I think, I will finish RCB first. So, I think that is all they need. They have that one slot empty. I think every other slot is filled. There are some which are extra. Like if you have if there is a Jadhav in CSK, there is a Yadav here. I have no idea what they want to do with him. So, he's there for whatever reason. I mean, he's basically, I don't think he even carries drinks nowadays. So, so they need to probably invest in a sort of a Karthik Tyagi type. There are youngsters around in this country. They need to invest in one youngster and hold on to him.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I mean, I was listening to some of the other commentators. They kept saying that the captain is as good as his team. I disagree with that. The point is the captain is responsible for his team. If the captain wants, he can get a mediocre team to perform well. Kapil's Devils is a big example. Kapil's Devils were not given a chance.
Shane Warne's Rajasthan Royals.
Yes, they were not given a chance. It's a question of how you instill that. And the biggest current example of IPL is, to me, Mumbai Indians. They didn't have a team when Rohit Sharma went that side. He suddenly became captain. He had no Ricky Ponting sat out, which is why he became captain. They didn't have a team. They were RCB of those days. How did they become Mumbai Indians of today? Because of consistency, because of supporting. You remember, Bala, you spoke about that. Rahul Chahar, despite a bad match, being allowed to lead the team out. Those are the gestures. That is the feeling that you want your players to have. And I think Kohli is missing a trick. Yesterday, twice it happened. I mean, again, exactly. You say cut him some slack. Twice it happened. I mean, one tough chance was missed. And another one where somebody was standing on the boundary. Siraj was standing on the boundary. He didn't come forward to...
Kind of words that Siraj used. I mean, Kohli used was... I mean, you didn't use that on your opponent, man.
Yeah, that's not acceptable. As a leader, that's not acceptable. You might be whatever you are. For me, the leader who actually castigates his team for every mistake is not a leader. I mean, I'm taking a huge...
That stood like a sore thumb, man.
Yeah,
that was not horrible.
I mean, imagine what they would feel, Bala. You and I are watching it. And look at what Rohit Sharma did. By the way, Rohit Sharma is not at all bad with his abuses. You can make out.
Yeah. I mean,
being from the Hindi heartland, I know when he is saying whatever he's saying. That is fine. But then you need to put an arm around somebody and say, you know what, it's okay. Fine. It's just a game. Now, I think that is where Kohli is missing a trick. Kohli genuinely needs somebody to put an arm around him and say, you know what, it's okay. It's fine. And then he needs to do that as a... Now, he's a senior statesman in the team. I think that is where RCB is missing out. It's not the team. I think that they have a good team now. They needn't go after Berserk, Hammer and Tongs for any new acquisitions or any transfer windows if it opens up before the next IPL. They don't need to do anything. At best, that...
And nothing drastic.
Yeah, middle order. I'm saying, if you think Josh Philippe is the guy, groom him for that. He's a young chap. You have one guy. Or you think Aaron Finch. Aaron Finch actually was batting at number 4 for Australia at one time. Remember? In the ODIs. So, I mean, figure it out.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So, in DC's case, I feel they are doing the same thing. I'll just finish this off. One sentence. DC's case, they're just giving too many options for Rishabh Pant. By which I mean, not opportunities, options. So Rishabh Pant should be
options.
Rishabh Pant should be sent in the 16th over. Son, you have
Raj, I'll just flip it. I mean, just I'll ask you this question.
Yeah, please.
This is I'll ask you a bizarre suggestion. I mean, since Prithvi Shah is not clicking, just to what to say, disrupt the whole thing. Would you open with Pant? Would you try?
I wouldn't do it now. I would have thought of it earlier. I think we did speak about this earlier. I would have said,
that's
the point.
That is a point.
Yeah, I would have said, I would have tried Rishabh Pant at the opening, just like RR did with, what's his name? Rajasthan Royals did with our
Ben Stokes.
I would have done it then. Yeah, after five matches when Prithvi was not getting, really, really showing his class. I would have said, okay, man, here is your chance. Next three matches, you're opening. Figure it out. See, my point is that,
you didn't try it in a semi-final situation.
Yeah, I mean, this is a do or die match. Do you want to try it? If it comes off, you look like a superstar. I mean, super idea. If it fails, you get brickbats. So, what is the choice they have? I have no clue. to open.
So, that's the reason. I mean, that is the trigger for my question. Since their options are limited, I thought they'll do something to disrupt the situation.
Yeah, I think.
Anyway, they are losing.
Yeah, I think they will again. I think in today, tomorrow's match also, they will again open, most probably open with Rahane and this guy. That is what I see. But then I don't know how they are going to make up the numbers. So the DC is not in a good position right now, unless some individual brilliance happens. I think for the match, the match will turn DC's way if there is an individual brilliance from some one player or two players. So like Rabada.
I mean, I would want Shreyas Iyer to come up with it because he has also had a very very average tournament, especially in the latter part.
Yes.
He needs to step up. And this is the best occasion for him to lead the team with the example.
So, I mean, I will counter that, put that question back to you, Bala. Shreyas Iyer as opener, he has done that before.
He has done that. I mean, that's very easy. And Shreyas Iyer is certainly a possibility.
Yeah.
Certainly
it's like
possibility.
It's like Rahul Dravid opening.
Anyway, Shreyas Iyer is certainly there. I just want to disrupt things. Because if it comes off, it can be great. Both for us as we are lay viewers and for DC as a team.
You have a point there. See, I'll tell you what is in favor of Pant. Pant probably likes the ball coming onto the bat.
Obviously.
Now, the only question is, there is Ashwin at the other end. Ashwin is in the...
No, man.
No, Ashwin is in the same team. Who's at the other end? They have people. I mean, SRH might not do that because SRH has been very stable with their opening combination. So, it's a good idea actually. I mean, if they sort of go ahead and try that, I mean, do you want to go for bust? I mean, look, think about it. Why not? Yeah. Anyways, you're bust.
So, busted.
You're busted.
Point,
so,
might as well.
Yeah, might as well go bust like this. So, I think
exactly.
But I think like I said, I will not use that word again, but that is with SRH. Yes, so, I'll put it that way. I think.
But just as a Bangalorean, tough luck this year, man, for you.
So it is, nothing has changed, no? So
nothing has changed, but I can say it. You are wearing black, man. I can see it.
that part is fine. That is largely because...
RCB won the... I mean, they were the best. They had the best social media team. So you won the social media cup.
Okay.
If at all it is any solace for you.
Yeah.
Which is... Because those Danish site videos were terrific.
So, I mean, maybe Danish Sheth should be part of the squad, man. I don't know. Maybe it will...
If not that squad, at least the bits and banter squad.
Yeah, definitely. No, even that squad, maybe because I think RCB sometimes takes things too seriously. They need to come and play the way... I mean, they need to enjoy. I mean, I saw traits of that in Virat Kohli in IPL, actually. In IPL, some matches, he was his flamboyant, happy self. And then suddenly he goes serious. So, I think that is where the thing is. Anyway.
That's a good point.
Better luck next
time. That is the right note to end this show.
Chalo, thanks.
Thanks, Raj.
So, we have some more offerings for you coming up today, tomorrow. While we wait for the other Eliminator 2. That sounds very weird. Luckily, they don't have a Terminator 1 and Terminator 2. Imagine what it would be if the first one is called Terminator 1. Terminator 2. So keep watching and that's all for the day. See you later. Bye-bye. Thanks, Bala.
Bye.
Being on air.